You know, if you look around Shoreline and Lake Forest Park, the art she brought has just been a pillar of creating community. And she's the person who gets things done. And she gets things done by doing those pieces that need to be done behind the scenes.
She likes to hide herself from great exposure. She's not one that wanted any publicity.
She's adding so much dimension and life to the community in which you live.
Well, I was on the board, of course, with her for many years and said, Roz, you have to take a salary for all this work you're doing. And she, oh, no, no, I enjoy doing it. I love this. So that, I think, shows so much about her character. Nobody I know would have spent that much time on an organization and be a volunteer.
And she could see a vision for enriching a community and bringing things in that would give a new identity to a new region.
Well, the community benefited from all the events that the Shoreline Lake Forest Park Arts Council started and has continued to have. The big festival, one of the biggest community arts festival around, and then performances that were designed to entertain many different type of audiences, from older adults, I would say, to young children's performances right here on the Shoreline Community College campus.
She got 5 or 6 pianos that were installed in various places. All of the pianos were painted richly. It brings people together, and they're having a good time, and they are loving their community in a new way.
She's so devoted to the arts in our community, that good art projects in all the arts, whether it be her visual arts or music or drama or dance.
And not only did she make choices, but she brought in other people to talk together, work in conference, and decide what's going to be best for the city. The City Hall is an amazing place, and as you look and see dogwood growing up the sides on the outside, and you see clouds and rains and glass and inside, you realize that Shoreline is a special place, and it took someone that had art deep in her heart and could help us see what we wanted to see to bring it to us.
The Lake Forest Park Garden Tour. That was an organization where we were trying to create a sense of community. And Roz sort of understands community as well as anybody I know. But very early on in that organization, I think at her recommendation, was that we take half of the revenue every year and create a fund for public art. After about 11 years, we had enough money in our art fund to create a signature piece of art that was in collaboration with the City of Lake Forest Park for their 50th anniversary.
Well, I hope that she will take this as a sincere token of gratitude that this community of some 60,000 people have for what she's been able to accomplish and what the efforts that she's put in. And we're very, very excited to be able to honor her and show this community's appreciation for what she's done for the entire arts community in our area.
She absolutely deserves this attention. She has done an extraordinary amount for these communities, Shoreline and Lake Forest Park. So I can't think of somebody who'd be better.
To be able to say a thank you for so much that has been done, so many hours of work, so much in bringing the right people together at the right time. And I really appreciate that we have a small way, at least, to say thank you, Roz. You've done so much for so many.